There's just a couple more things I'd like to cover here in the drawings that I haven't talked about yet. So in this one drawing we had here, we just backed up one, right? And you'll see these yellow warnings sometimes when you maybe go back to the model or change something, and it's telling you that there's something not quite right. And if you right click on the yellow little warning flag, it says delete or reassociate. And what it's saying here is that there's something wrong with its connection to the line, or you know, it just doesn't know what it's pointing at. So if you click on delete, obviously it deletes the dimension. If you hit reassociate, it gives you a little square, right? And that kind of shows you where it really thinks it's at. And you need to redo this, you know, so reselect the item that you want to have selected. And here in this case, it's not letting me really do something here about selecting that. Sometimes that's what happens with those. And you know, you can sit here and play with it. And it's just about better just say delete and redo it on something like that. You just waste a lot of time. And reselect your edge here. It's not even letting me redo it here. Let's try this one. Let's do a reassociate. And usually you can reselect there. That's what you should get, that little green like square, and reselect where that should be attached, and you'll remove that warning. I don't know why that did not. Let me see if I can get a radius dimension back in here. Oh, it's just not wanting to let me redo that for some reason. But I just want to show you how you can redo those warnings to get rid of them. Then the other one I want to talk about is your tables here. Now, when you create a table like this, you can't come in here and edit the text and what it says. You can edit a few things. So double clicking on it, you get a dialog box over here, and you can select the columns. So if you don't want, if the description's going to be empty, if you don't want to just unhide that, you can just hide that column, right? Or if you don't want to have the quantity in there, even if it's only going to be one of them, you know, you might not want that. So you can change that. But let's talk about this though. The steel. Back up a second here. And where does it get this information, the part number type thing? Well, that is the description when you're making your model, you know, over here in your browser part that you've typed in. That's what that description ends up being, that part number. That's where they get that information. So you could go back to your model and change that if you want to say something different. But the material it lists over here is not the material you put in as an appearance material, but the a material that you've put in as your physical material. And we'll close this. So if you want this to represent really what things are, you need to go and change that in the model. Now, mine shows steel because that is what my default value is with the program. And then up here at your name, click on preferences, and you can change whatever the default value is when you start your drawings. And you go to material, and this is where you can set that, the physical material category and name, and they're drop down lists, and you select what you want to start with. And then the appearance also, what you would want to start with, okay? So that's where it got this information, because that's what I made the model with. So if we go back to the model, now we made the piston assembly as a separate drawing. See, it's an assembly and the piston and all that. Where is that at? Oh, there it is. Okay, so we'll open up the piston assembly, right? And we have appearances in here. We have steel, we have bronze, and we have brass. But those are, like I said, appearances. And let's go to the bushing, okay? And we'll start with that one. And we right click on it, and we have over here appearances and physical material. So select physical material, and you'll get another dialog box, of course, and then you can choose what material you want. Now they have a lot of stuff in here. This is what under metal, right? Under metal, and we could, let's see here, there's some bronze, and it's going to be pretty shiny bronze, so let's just put that up here, and we'll go in here and select the bushing as bronze, right? And you can close that. The piston, it's physical material, the piston, and let's make it brass. Brass, nice shiny brass. Let's save that up there, and we'll do that. And the nut will be brass, right? And O-ring, right? We got to find a rubber. I've never had to look for a rubber, but under miscellaneous, well, there's paper. They might not give you these options here. Plastic, ceramics, fabric, flooring, fabric, I don't know. Nope. Flooring. So we don't have we're not getting a lot of options here. Good metal, isn't it? Plastic. Lots of options in plastic, it looks like. Oh, rubber. Well, there you go. Rubber's right there. Rubber. Black rubber, butyl, here. We could have a nice butyl O-ring. Let's see, there we go. There we go. And the nut is, like I said, what's the nut? The nut is going to be brass. And we'll make sure it's brass, there we go. So we did everything. The piston was steel, or the piston rod was steel, and that was the default. We've adjusted our physical materials, and we have our appearances in there and everything. Now we want to save it. There, I adjusted the physical materials. We'll just put something in there. Now we'll have to go back, once that saves, we'll go back here to the full engine, right? And it's going to have a warning flag, right? And we're going to click on the warning flag, and it's going to update, recalculate and update the model. There we go. It did that. And we can save that. I'm not going to type anything in. And then after it saves it, we'll go here to the drawings. Hopefully it's going to say we need to update it. And it does. It says we need to update that. And if you select on here, it's going to tell you everything. Oh, everything needs to be updated. We'll select that. And things got updated. Now we have a table that says piston is brass, piston rod is steel, bushing is bronze, brass nut, and a rubber butyl O-ring. So that's how you can get the right materials in your little table there. And the other thing here on these pre-made templates, these are editable. You can double click and then double click on that, and you can write whatever you want in there, right? And all these other blocks, okay? So that's pretty easy. I'll do a tips video or something on making templates. It's not too hard to do. It's pretty easy. You can have your own templates for your drawings you make. And let's see. So that's about it. And the next videos, or the next video, this is what I plan on doing in the next video, is we'll talk about exploded views and how to make them. And it'll be pretty interesting. They're kind of fun to make, actually, compared to the other parts of the other drawings. But it will take 30, 40 minutes probably to talk about the entire process of doing this. But these are good to have if you're having a multi-part object. It explains how it goes together or how it comes apart. You can, label it and all that good stuff. But we'll talk about that in the next video. So thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Please click the notification bell so you get notified when a new video comes up and everything. I hope you guys are still enjoying this. I really enjoy making these videos. I really enjoy this subject, I should say. Let me know what you think. Please write comments. If you have any questions, I'll try to answer them. So we'll catch you in the next one. Thank you.